Today is a very special day. Not only are we here at the Moto Guzzi factory near Lake Como, probably the most oldest and historic motorcycle factories in the world, but we're also here to ride the new Stelvio. This is actually a pre-production model. The first one hasn't even been made yet, but we've been given special access to ride this bike, which Guzzi reckon is going to topple the BMW GS.
Right, we're going to go for a spin. Now, this bike is called the Stelvio, which is named after the Stelvio Pass, that really wiggly road that's really famous in pictures. But that's about 200 miles away and covered in snow. So what we're going to do is actually go up into the mountains near Lake Como and give this bike a go. And I can't wait.
You can see why Moto Guzzi fancied a slice of BMW's action. The GS is one of the top selling bikes in the UK, in with all the best selling sports bikes. But to topple the BMW, it's going to need a fair few weapons in its armoury.
So the Stelvio has been designed as a dual purpose bike, very much in the same vein as a BMW R1200GS. It's a completely new bike with a new chassis and a new 1200 8 valve V-twin engine. Very comfortable. Comfy seat, which is two-way adjustable. It's on its lowest setting at the moment. It goes up a little bit as well, and it's quite sporty as well. We've got radial brakes. I've never seen radial brakes on an adventure bike before. 50mm fully adjustable Marzocchi forks. We've got Pirelli tyres and a 180 section at the back, which is something you normally find on a sports bike. And this is a nice little gadget, electronically operated cubby hole. That's to the tank, which you can keep your wallet and your phone or whatever in, which is really handy. At the back end, one of the good things about Guzzi's is its shaft drive, so it's maintenance free. This is a new design shaft drive which also incorporates a swing arm, and there's less up and down movement when you get on the throttle with it. Rear shock fully adjustable with a preload adjuster which you can get to by a knob, by hand if you want to change it for passengers or luggage. Also, as you can see, the off-road styling, we've also got dual purpose tyres. Now, the off-road ability of this bike is really restricted by these tyres, which even on this snow here slips and slides. And also there's not a lot of clearance down under the mudguard, so you're not going to get any real serious off-roading done, although there is a lot of other ground clearance. So that's the technical stuff over with. I think right now it'd be rude not to have a spin on it. Through these mountain roads, the big Stelvio is remarkably agile and sure-footed. Around town, it's very nimble for a bike weighing 214 kilos. And it's fast too. Keep the engine spinning above 6,000 RPM and it really gets a move on. But the best bit of the Guzzi is how relaxed and comfortable it is. There's lots of leg room and the adjustable screen keeps off the wind blast at speed. So what do we think then? Well, what I'd say is this is typical modern day Guzzi, and that is a really good thing, because over the last couple of years their new range of models, which started with the Breva and the Grisso, the Norge, and now this, are all beautifully made, really nicely designed, very smooth, very comfortable to ride. Also, you've got the Moto Guzzi badge on the tank and that throbbing V-twin engine to remind you that you're on something a little bit special and something with a little bit of history. Is it a BMW beater? Well, it's hard to say. It's very, very different, I can tell you that. It's not as serious as a BMW. It's not quite as fast as a BMW, but this is easier to hustle around than a BM. It's physically smaller, and it handles more like a normal bike. With these Marzocchi forks, radial brakes, decent tyres, it actually gets through the twisties really well, and it's got a good bit of top end stomp as well. It's got 100 brake horsepower, this engine, and you've got to rev it. It's an 8 valve engine compared to the old 4 valve engines, but you've got to keep it on song and then it really does go. It's got good low down power as well, but there's a little bit missing in the middle. But we've spoken to the Guzzi guys, and because this is a pre-production bike that is being looked at as we speak, the fuel mapping is going to be redesigned before it goes on sale. Talking of going on sale, it's going to be in the UK around about mid-March, and although the prices haven't been finalised yet, it's going to be about $8,000, so that puts it about $1,000 cheaper than the BMW, and I think it's a great bike.